I don't think anyone is new in the room, but I guess I'll reintroduce Masayuki again. So this is the Cloud Containers and DevOps track. Masayuki Igawa is a senior software engineer at SUSE and an OpenStack developer. And he's going to be talking about free and open source Kubernetes management tools. So without further ado, Masayuki.
Okay, thanks. Okay. So I will talk about, I'm Masayuki Igawa, and I will talk about free open source software Kubernetes management tools. So this slide is on here. And so my GitHub, Twitter, Freenode is Masayuki G. So if you have any question or contacts, please ping me on that. Yes. And I think almost the people are the same, right? So I'm an OpenStack upstream or downstream programmer. And my job is a quality assurance in upstream or and downstream. I mean, I'm working at the SUSE. I'm also a quality assurance member of the SUSE OpenStack Cloud. And I'm also a Mesos user group in Tokyo. So yeah, this is it's a bit update profile. And in this talk, I'd like to talk about Kubernetes. So why I like to talk about the Kubernetes. Here's a reason. So first one is it's a famous and interesting topic. Yeah, technology. So today or previous days, many people are talking about Kubernetes or Docker or like that. So I'd like to know the technology. So I tested some in my cloud. So and it's a free open source software. And I also use it in my cloud. I mean, not Google Cloud or Amazon Cloud or Azure. So I'd like to talk about my private cloud. It's a 3 1U servers plus one workstations. It's powered by the LuckRack. It's already talked about Matthew in this morning from 10 a.m. Yeah, already talked about that. It's very similar. The difference is servers spec and the number of servers. So if you want to see more, if you direct to more, you can see the GitHub pages of Masterius. So, and the difference is also Linux distribution and the OpenStack distribution. I used the OpenStack Queens version on OpenSUSE Leap 42.3 version, and set up it from a distribution, OpenStack distribution. I mean, just use a package, not a turbo or Git source. So it's really simple, and I have no trouble with that, basically. But there are some issues on that is network. I built it in a very flat network. VMs are connected to my home router, so it's very simple network. I can show you my network environment. Well, let me. Okay. Yeah, like this. So VMs are connected to my home router. directory, and my workstation also connected to the router. So it's very flat. So I don't need to split the network. I don't want to split the network because it's a bit complicated to me. So here's what is Kubernetes. Maybe you already know that, but it's a container orchestration tools. It has a lot of features like self-healing, automatic binary packaging, horizontal scaling, auto scaling, load balance, something like that. And it's open source. But I've heard that it's a bit difficult to deploy it in, especially in a production environment. So I'd like to use it in easily. So I checked some first tools. So why we should use first tools? It's free, not only money, but also we can use. You can see the source code. And we can know that everything, it should be fun, right? And I have the resource, I have the my cloud, I can run on that. And first, Kubernetes tools, there are some tools like this. Minikube is a kind of a, I think this is a, not only for, this is not for a production environment. It's only for developers test environment. And the second one is OpenStack Magnum is one of the OpenStack projects. I'll talk about that later. And the third one is Mesos, DCOS, and Launcher. So I'd like to talk about a bit about Magnum. It's an OpenStack project. And it's API services for container orchestration engines. So this Magnum not only supports Kubernetes, but also supports Docker Swarm or Apache Mesos. And I read the document, and it's will support DCOS too, but not yet probably. And Mesos DCOS is Mesos and DCOS is a kind of different, but DCOS is based on Mesos, right? So Mesos is abstract CPU memory storage and rather compute resources. This is similar like OpenStack, but it's also enabling the fault tolerant and the elastic distributed system to easily build and run effectively. DCOS is called a data center OS. Is an open source distributed operating system. It has more features compared to the Mesos. And I think DCOS is one of the point is it has a fancy catalogs. So probably I can show you if I have a time later. Yeah. And you can see that information here. And the Launcher is open source too. And it's a container management platform and deploy and manage the Kubernetes with ease. So I tried to use it and I found that it's very easy to use it as a first step, as a starting point. And this also has a fancy catalog. So it's really good. I think. So there is a pros cons. I tried to use Magnum and the DCOS and the Rancher. So here is a pros cons. Yeah. So first, I tried to use a Magnum, but I failed to build the environment. It's there are some reasons. One reason is Magnum requires a separated network. It's not doesn't fit my OpenStack environment. So it's one of the reason. But so if I can use Magnum, it should be used with the standard APIs, I mean the OpenStack API. So if you are very familiar with the OpenStack API, it should be good option. And the second is the Mesos DCOS. I need to change the sentences. Yeah. So Mesos is needs several nodes at least. Is one of the issue not issue bad point, but good point is it already has a fault tolerant, so it should be good point too. And Rancher is it can be start from one node. It's really good. Good to use, so people doesn't have a lot of nodes, basically. So it's really good. And Kubernetes CLI included, and but I think CLI for to manage the Rancher is poor or not, and none. So but. There is some APIs, so we can use that from that API if we want to use it from the CLI. So for future work, this future work is just for my project. I mean, for my private cloud. So I need a real use case to use like this Kubernetes management tools. So one option, one candidate is IoT things. It should require a lot of resources or like that. And as a tester environment is also good use case for Kubernetes. And I think I should have more stable infrastructure, but it's not so unstable for my OpenSUSE 42.3 right now. So it's not so high priority. And the third one is introduce network isolation to use OpenStack Magnum or like standard OpenStack cloud. And the last one is, I'd like to use Magnum. So here's the conclusion. We can play the Kubernetes with the post tools easier, and having a private cloud is very fun. So I'd like to show you a kind of demo. If I still connected to the my cloud. So here's my cloud dashboard. So it's not so different from the standard OpenStack cloud. So, but you can see already I have 8 VMs on my cloud, and there's some variety of the VMs. I run the OpenSUSE, Debian, Rancher OS, and the CentOS, like that. So if we have the private cloud, we can run a lot of VMs like this. And I'd like to show you the DCOS dashboard. It should be work. This is work on my cloud, but there are some network issues probably. Yeah, so it doesn't work. But yeah, if it works, we can see there are a lot of application catalog on that page, and just click the applications, it will be deployed to the DCOS Mesos cloud. So it's really easy to use that. So I think this doesn't work actually. So this is the end of the week. It's how many hours? Okay. So that's all from me. Thanks.
Questions?
So any questions in this part or the previous CLI part? Yeah, whenever, whichever you want. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.